Authority, the owner and founder of the most famous Wild West show on earth. You're now going to see my own personal version of the tempestuous and exciting times in the search for Miss Texas 2000. Ladies and gents, let the show begin with our own Miss Texas, Yancy Yarbrough.
There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing. Everything the traffic will.
Auditorium in Fort Worth is the 2000 Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant, the official preliminary to the Miss America Pageant in Atlantic City. Starring our current Miss Texas and fourth runner-up to Miss America, Yancy Yarbrough. Featuring Danny Parkerson as Buffalo Bill and featured vocalist Dave Cave. And from Johnny High's Country Music Review, Kaylee Irwin, Kimmeri Trojanowski, Casey Trojanowski, Jeffrey Allen, with the Miss Texas Dancers, the award-winning Bruce Lee Dance Factory, Rick Stitzel and the Miss Texas Orchestra, and the Boswell High School Pure Gold Dance Team. The Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant is brought to you by Chevrolet. Chevy, we'll be there. Nice and easy from Clairol, it's the true color of you. Lotto Texas, Scratch Games, the Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant, what do they all have in common? They can make people winners, and they're all brought to you courtesy of the Texas Lottery. Good luck, everybody. Chili's Grill and Bar, proud sponsor of the 2000 Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant, and proud to have been serving Texans for more than 25 years. We'll see y'all at Chili's. meet all of our contestants after this word from Chevrolet, a proud sponsor of the Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant since 1988. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome this evening's co-host, former Miss Texas Gloria Gilbert Barron, and from KPRC TV Channel 2 in Houston, television personality Frank Billingsley.
Thank you, and good evening. You look terrific.
Well, so do you, Frank.
I tell you, it's hot outside, but we have a cool show in here. It's such a thrill to be here once again in Fort Worth and be a part of this year's Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant, the first one of the 21st century.
That's right, and what a show we have to begin this new century. Tonight, we'll be touring the world with Buffalo Bill Cody, one of the most colorful figures of the Old West.
That's right.
His Old West show introduced Americana and American culture to audiences from England and continental Europe, to the remote and exotic locations in Central and South America. But now for the business at hand.
That's right. Let's get to it. It's time to meet our contestants, one of whom will become the next Miss Texas and possibly our new Miss America. Gloria, take it away.
Here we go. Miss Abilene.
Sophomore at Abilene Christian University.
Miss Amarillo area.
Miranda Carter, a graduate of the University of North Texas.
Miss Anderson County.
Audra Sanders, a sophomore attending the University of Houston.
Miss Angelina County.
Sabrina Lavoy, attending Sam Houston State University.
Miss Argyle.
Alexis Young, a sophomore attending Baylor University.
Miss Arlington.
Brooke Kibler, attending the University of Texas at Arlington.
Miss Bear County.
Destiny Martin, a freshman attending Southwest Texas State University.
Miss Brownfield.
Stephanie Stokes, attending Texas Tech University.
Miss Burleson.
Shannon Sturdivant, attending the University of North Texas.
Miss Collin County.
Georgia Locke, attending Stephen F. Austin State University.
Miss Conroe.
Felina Talamoth, a freshman attending Texas A&M University.
Miss Dallas.
Morgan Matlock, attending Texas Tech University.
Miss Denton County.
Tammy St. Dawn, attending the University of Texas at Dallas.
Miss East Texas.
Kayla Carver, attending the University of North Texas.
Miss El Paso area.
Tanika Davenport, attending Collin County Community College.
Miss Ellis County.
Lauren Blackwood, attending Texas Christian University.
Miss Farmers Branch.
Misty McNeese, attending the University of North Texas.
Miss Fort Worth.
Marshawn Evans, attending Texas Christian University.
Miss Garland.
Ellie Jarrett, attending Baylor University.
Miss Gulf Coast.
Cindy Elizondo, attending Texas A&M University.
Miss Harris County.
Tori White, attending the University of Texas at Austin.
Miss Houston.
Wendy Turner, a graduate of Houston Baptist University.
Miss Humble Kingwood.
Andrea Coots, a senior at Louisiana State University.
Miss Hunt County.
Sarah Sheffield, a senior at the University of North Texas.
Miss Hurst Ulis Bedford.
Tara Watson, attending Texas Christian University.
Miss Jefferson County.
Claire Propp, the graduate of Baylor University.
Miss Katie.
Melissa Ragsdale, a junior attending the University of Houston.
Miss Lake Cities.
Carrie Myers, attending Texas Christian University.
Miss Lake of the Pines.
Alex Gorman, attending Texas A&M University.
Miss Lake Ray Hubbard.
Elisa Behrens, a graduate student at Texas Christian University.
Miss Lone Star.
Melissa Pritchett, a sophomore at Sam Houston State University.
Miss Lubbock.
Angie Clark, attending Texas Tech University School of Law.
Miss Lufkin.
Megan Gilbride, a junior attending Stephen F. Austin State University.
Miss Montgomery County.
Danielle Robertson, attending Texarkana College.
Miss Nacogdoches.
Casey Porter, attending Stephen F. Austin State University.
Miss North Texas.
Sarah Miller, a senior attending Baylor University.
Miss Northeast Tarrant County.
Holly McCullough, a freshman at the University of Texas at Arlington.
Arlington.
Miss Oak Cliff.
Brooke Bowie attending Amber University.
Miss Parker County.
Alex Konechny attending Texas Wesleyan University.
Miss Piney Woods area.
Aaron Ruckel attending Lawn Morris College.
Miss Richardson.
Krista Medlock attending Southern Methodist University.
Miss Rio Grande Valley.
Jennifer Charlotte attending University of Texas at Arlington.
Miss River Oaks.
Lisa Dalzell, a senior attending Texas A&M University.
Miss San Angelo.
Chrissy Bridges, a senior at Angelo State University.
Miss San Antonio.
Samantha Batten attending the University of Texas in San Antonio.
Miss South Plains.
Julie Morphis attending West Texas A&M University.
Miss Southeast Texas.
Ashley Golden attending Angelina College.
Miss Sulphur Springs area.
Dia Dodson attending Parker College of Chiropractic.
Miss Tarrant County.
Heather Wood, a graduate of Texas Christian University.
Miss Texarkana.
Jesse Ward attending the University of Arkansas at Little Rock.
Miss Texas Panhandle.
Wendy Brizendine, a junior attending West Texas A&M University.
Miss Top of Texas area.
Erica Charlton attending Texas Tech University.
Miss Walker County.
Kristen Little attending Angelina College.
Miss West Texas.
Megan Webster attending Southwest Texas State University.
Miss White Settlement.
Adriana Elizondo, a graduate of St. Mary's University.
Miss Wise County.
Bridget Booth, attending the University of North Texas.
Miss Woodlands.
Marlise Fitch, attending Baylor University.
Last year on this stage, a charming and beautiful young lady representing the cities of Hearst, Euless, Bedford went on to receive that unforgettable honor. Her sincerity, intellect, talent, and beauty charmed our audience and last year's judges. And in September of last year, she was named fourth runner-up to Miss America. Please welcome Miss Texas, Yancy Yarbrough.
You know, you're one of the best. You're one in a million. You've been so good for our state. You've been so good for our young people. We're going to miss you so much. You've had an outstanding year. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Yancy Yarbrough, everybody.
The Miss Texas organization believes in educational rewards for its participants. Through generous donations, each contestant will receive an educational scholarship from the Miss Texas organization. That's great. And additionally, for the past several years, the Miss Texas organization has allowed Miss Texas to award two special scholarships to male high school students that she has met during her visits around the state. With us tonight are the two students I have selected as the recipients of the $1,000 Beat On Magnus Texas Cares for Children Scholarship. Please welcome Brooke Davis from Rice High School and Ty Porter from Ozona High School. Congratulations and best wishes from the Miss Texas organization.
Thank you, Yancy. Tonight, the 10 women who have accumulated the greatest number of points during our week of preliminary competition will go on to become our semifinalists.
Yep.
Frank, are you ready to make this exciting announcement?
I've got them right here. The points from the preliminary competition have been tabulated, and our top 10 semifinalists are Miss Harris County, Tori White. Miss Lubbock, Angie Clark. Miss Amarillo, Miranda Carter. Euless, Bedford, Tara Watson. Miss River Oaks, Lisa Dalzell.
Our next five semifinalists are Miss Oak Cliff. Brooke Bowie. Miss Gulf Coast, Cindy Elizondo. Miss Dallas, Morgan Matlock. Miss Fort Worth, Marshawn Evans. And Miss Collin County, Georgia Locke.
Oh, this is going to be a good one. Congratulations, ladies. One of these 10 outstanding young women will become your Miss Texas 2000. Stay with us. There's no place like home.
The memories are made there every day. Collecting charm, function, and impeccable service, there's really only one choice. The Renaissance Worthington Hotel in Fort Worth.
And Miss America programs reward accomplished young women who demonstrate artistic and academic excellence and are concerned with and committed to bettering the world in which they live. The Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant 2 rewards its participants with cash and in-kind scholarships, which this year, Frank, will exceed $2.5 million.
$2.5 million.
How about that?
Earlier this week, contestants had a 12-minute interview with our panel of judges, which counts for a possible 30% of their total score. In addition, they compete in talent, which adds 40%, and evening wear and swimsuit, which adds an additional 15% each. It's important to remember that the points accumulated during preliminary competitions are all thrown out, the exception being the interview scores. The judges will cast new scores tonight for each phase of onstage competition.
I'm glad I'm not a judge tonight.
Me too, but who are they?
Well, they have a difficult task of selecting Miss Texas to follow in Yancey's footsteps. Let's meet them now. Rick Pruitt was affiliated with the Miss Arkansas pageant for 17 years and have been co-producer and chair of the local pageant franchises and the judges committee. Having judged across the country, welcome Rick Pruitt. Natalie Evitz Hart has the unusual distinction of knowing the pageant world from virtually every angle as contestant, MC, television co-host, business person, donor, and supporter. Natalie is currently a consultant for TravelClick, a computer software company. Let's greet our own Natalie Evitz Hart. Music director, vocal arranger, and conductor, developing musicals with a wide variety of directors, composers, and author. Carl German presently serves as conductor of the Tony Award-winning musical, The Lion King. Carl is also twice judged the Miss America pageant. Give a large Texas howdy to Carl German. Libby Taylor is CEO and Executive Director of the Miss Kentucky Scholarship Organization, the proud home of our current Miss America, Heather French. Libby teaches history and economics and is the coach and choreographer of the Tates Creek High School dance team. From Lexington, here is Libby Taylor. Vice President of Marketing and Community Relations for the Manatee Memorial Hospital and Health System and Executive Director of the Hospital Foundation, Vernon DeSeer joins us from Bradenton, Florida. Vernon has judged some 40 Miss America state pageants as well as the 1989 and 1991 Miss America pageants. We welcome back Vernon DeSeer. A high school vocal music director and dance coach for 28 years, Okima Crawford served as musical director for the Miss Indiana pageant, an experienced local and state pageant judge, including here at the Miss Texas pageant. Say hello to Okima Crawford. former producer and director of the Miss Texas pageant, and for 13 years holding the same posts for the Miss Ohio pageant. Denny Keller served as talent coach and grooming advisor for Miss Ohio, having judged over 300 pageants in 39 states. He's also judged the 1992 Miss America pageant. Please greet R. Denison, Denny Keller. And last but certainly not least, we'd like to recognize our auditors, Marvin Blum and Craig Hamilton. The Miss Texas organization is an all-volunteer group, which is also true of all Miss America franchises. We would not be able to present such a program without the volunteers, sponsors, and donors who give so willingly of their time, services, and merchandise. At this time, it is my privilege to introduce these gold-level donors, educational institutions who are offering generous, in-kind scholarships to contestants this year. Please extend your appreciation to Arlington Medical Institution, Thad and Dr. Alicia Smotherman, Houston Baptist University, Richard Parker, Lawn Morris College, Dr. Clifford Lee, Northwood University, Mindy McReynolds, and Our Lady of the Lake University. Our representative was unable to be here, but we thank them graciously. The following organizations and businesses are also at the gold level of sponsorship. Let's show our appreciation to these major donors. Fort Worth Convention and Visitors Bureau, Doug Harmon. Mike Miller and Associates Special Events, Mike Miller. Gardier and Wynn, LLP, Debbie Bagley. RB Contractors, Randy and Valerie Brown. Reflections Boutique and Salon, Lois Morris. Bedford Hotel Motel Association, Kara Hensley and Terry Cottle. Drug Prevention Resources, Phil Watson. Craig Hamilton and Captain EPC, Craig Hamilton. Let's thank them for all their wonderful support of the Miss Texas pageant. Thank you.
I'm very proud to be identified with the Wild West. But a lot of you folk don't know that I took my show on the road to Europe, where we got to experience all the cultures that the continent had to offer. In fact, the beautiful melodies brought forth in Andrea Bocelli's Time to Say Goodbye form a perfect backdrop for our evening wear competition.
Quando se non tono sogno all'orizzonte mancan le parole, e io sì lo so che sei con me, tu mia luna tu sei qui con me, mio sole tu sei qui con me, con me, con me.
Texas semifinalists in evening wear competition. Miss Harris County, Tori White. Miss Lubbock, Angie Clark. Miss Amarillo, Miranda Carter. Ms. Hurst, Julis Bedford, Tara Watson. Miss River Oaks, Lisa Dalzell. Miss Oak Cliff, Brooke Bowie. Miss Gulf Coast, Cindy Elizondo. Dallas, Morgan Matlock. Miss Fort Worth, Marshawn Evans. Miss Collin County, Georgia Locke. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the evening wear competition. Talent competition is coming up next.
Great resume. What else you got?
I want my baby back, baby back.
Our pleasure to welcome you.
Holiday Inn, a quality performer hotel.
Another distinctive component of the Miss America and Miss Texas competition is the emphasis on the creative and performing arts through the talent competition. Contestants have used the exposure they have received through state and nationwide television audiences as virtual springboards for professional careers in musical theater, the Broadway stage, the recording industry, and television and movies. Let's begin tonight's talent competition. Presenting the showstopper, I Want More, written just for women, and a few men. Please welcome Tori White, Miss Harris County.
Day in and out, what my life's all about are the things that you find far too boring. Washing and cooking and staying good looking while you get to do the ignoring. Will it ever be my turn to say where we're going? Will it ever be my life that we're planning for? I've been living this way for so long without growing. I want more, I want more. I want shapeless sonnets, I want oohs and ahs. I want long stem roses in a Gucci vase. Kisses that go on for days. I want more than this is in so many ways. I want more relating, I want less debating. I want all those things I'm waiting for. So in case you're listening, if you want me, I want more. I want to fly to that storybook sky where two people in love always travel. I want to be like some deep mystery you simply can't wait to unravel. I want to soar 10 feet off of the floor when you walk through the door like I used to before. I want magic carpets, I want true romance, moonlight cruises to the sound of brown.
She Loves Me tells the story of two secret pen pals who fall in love. This same tale spurred the storyline for the recent hit film, You've Got Mail. Here to sing Vanilla Ice Cream is Angie Clark, Miss Lubbock.
Dear friend, I am so sorry about last night. It was a nightmare in every way. But together, you and I will laugh at last night someday. Ice cream, he brought me ice cream, vanilla.
wonders never cease. Will wonders never cease? It's been a most peculiar day. Will wonders never cease? Will wonders never cease? Oh, where was I? I am so sorry about last night. It was a nightmare in every way, but together you and I will have last night someday. I sat there waiting in that cafe and never guessing that you were fat. That you were near. You were outside looking bald. Bald? Oh my. Dear friend, I am so sorry about last night. Last night, I was so nasty. Well, he deserved it, but even so, that George is not like this George. This is a new George that I don't know. Somehow, it all reminds me of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Before my eyes, a man that I despise has turned into a man I like. It's almost like a dream, as strange as it may seem. He came to offer me vanilla.
People always ask me where I got my auburn hair. From my mother.
Background for the voices of legendary entertainers Frank Sinatra and Liza Minnelli. Dancing to unstoppable rhythms of I've Got the World on a String is Miranda Carter, Miss Amarillo Area.
I've got the world on a string, sitting on a rainbow.
Got the string around my finger.
What a world, what a life I'm in love. Thing. As long as I hang on to the string, I'd be a silly so-and-so if I should ever let it go.
Here we go, don't you know, you can never let go.
Got the world on a string, sitting on a rainbow.
Got the string around my finger.
What a world, what a life, I am in love. Life's a wonderful thing.
Life is a wonderful thing.
Long as I hang on to the string, be a silly so and so.
Be a silly so and so.
If I should ever let it go,
just let it go.
I've got the world on a string,
and I'm sitting on a rainbow.
Got that string around my finger. What a world!
Well, your first crush can be a bittersweet memory. George and Ira Gershwin set those feelings to music and words in their classic ballad, I've Got a Crush on You. Here to express these feelings is Tara Watson, Miss Hurst Euless Bedford.
How glad the many millions Tom's and Dick's and William's would be. Such persistence, you wore down my resistance. I fell and it was so well. You're my big and brave and handsome Romeo. How I won you, I will never, never know. It's not that you're attractive, but oh, my heart grew active when you came into. I've got a crush on you, sweetie boy. All the day and night time, hear me sigh. I never had the least notion that I could fall with so much emotion. Could you care for a cunning cottage we could share? The world would pardon my mush, 'cause I've got a crush, my baby, on you.
America's favorite Andrew Lloyd Webber hits are Don't Cry for Me, Argentina, The Phantom of the Opera, and The Jellicoe Ball. Here to perform her version of these on the flute, please welcome Lisa Dalzell, Miss River Oaks.
Thank you.
When risk collides with opportunity, and it's as good as it's going to get, then it's time to take a chance, whether in life or in love. Here singing It's Time is Brooke Bowie, Miss Oak Cliff.
It's time to hold my hand and take a chance. It's time to pay the band and start the dance. We hear the melody, we know the song. It's time, I think, we're on the brink of waiting far too long. Why not believe our eyes and cross our hearts, dispense with alibis, enough false starts. It's time to put away our childish things, and time to trust in us and what tomorrow brings. It's time to risk it. Just let go and fall. It's not too soon.
This week, I gave myself a pedicure.
And all-in-one savings.
Welcome back to the 2000 Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant as we continue our talent competition. Music is the universal language, and Chopin was the greatest composer of this language. Here to perform Chopin's Scherzo No. 1 in B minor, Opus 20, is Cindy Elizondo, Miss Gulf Coast. Thank you. realizing the mistake she has made, Effie decides to make a change, singing "I Am Changing." From the Broadway musical Dreamgirls is Morgan Matlock, Miss Dallas.
Look at me. Look at me. I am changing, trying every way I can. I am changing. I'll be better than I am. I'm trying to find a way to understand, but I need you. I need a hand. All my life I've been a fool. Who said I could do it all alone? How many good friends have already
like home. It has a certain magic all its own.
For elegance, charm, function, and impeccable service, there's really only one choice: the Renaissance Worthington Hotel in Fort Worth.
Offering a dynamic message of inspiration with a beat that breaks the conventions of pop and disco through a rhythmic dance twirl to I Will Survive is Marshawn Evans, Miss Fort Worth.
Then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong, and I grew strong, and I learned how to get along. Bye.
Puccini's opera, La Rondinée, the spirited Magda sings of her dreams of a kiss so ardent that it outweighs the importance of wealth, frenzied love, and frenzied rapture to be able to love like that. Welcome, Georgia Locke, Miss Collin County. Fort Worth, the home of the Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant, but also this part of the state is home to some very talented people. I have the privilege of knowing Johnny High, a man who has been responsible for furthering the careers of many now well-known artists when they were just starting out, such as Linda Davis, Leanne Womack, and of course, Grammy and Country Music Association Award winner Leanne Rimes. Join us now in a tribute to Johnny High as we present some new rising stars. Ladies and gentlemen, Kaylee Irvin. Janowski.
Well, I never felt more like singing the blues, 'cause I never thought that all of the loser would be. Why'd you do me this way? Well, I never felt more like crying all night, 'cause everything's wrong and nothing ain't right without you. You gotta sing the blues.
Now a big Texas hello to Mr. Jeffrey Allen.
Well, you say you're not from Texas. Man, as if I can tell. You think you'd pull your boots on that and wear your hat so well. Oh, so pardon me, my laughter, as I sure do understand. Even when he saw that promised land. Oh, that's right, you're not from Texas. That's right, you're not from Texas. That's right, you're not from Texas. But Texas won't do anyway. That's right, you're not from Texas. That's right, you're not from Texas. That's right, you're not from Texas. But Texas won't do anyway. So won't you let me help you, mister, and pull your hat down the way I do. Oh, and buy your pants just a little longer. And next time someone laughs at you just tell them you're not from Texas. That's right, you're not from Texas. That's right, you're not from Texas. Texas won't you anyway.
George Rachel, not from Texas.
Wow, wasn't that some great talent? Johnny, we love you. Now let's begin the next phase of competition, physical fitness in swimsuit, with Miss Harris County, Tori White. Miss Lubbock, Angie Clark. Miss Amarillo, Miranda Carter. Ms. Hurst, Euless Bedford, Tara Watson. Miss River Oaks, Lisa Dalzell. Miss Oak Cliff, Brooke Bowie. Miss Gulf Coast, Cindy Elizondo. Miss Dallas, Morgan Matlock. Miss Fort Worth, Marshawn Evans. Miss Collin County, Georgia Locke. That concludes this evening's swimsuit competition. Next, we'll narrow it down to our five finalists right after this.
This was fun, and I was thinking maybe we could go back to my place. And
welcome you!
Holiday Inn, a quality performer hotel.
Our new Miss Texas will have an extremely busy year of service, as she will make between 400 and 500 appearances throughout the state of Texas.
Wow.
As well as her journey to Atlantic City for the Miss America pageant. On her many appearances, she will enjoy being impressively wardrobed in jewelry by Joe Wilmoth of Opulence for JW Limited. And for those chilly fall days, her beautiful fur coat is compliments of David Hunt Furs, represented by David Hunt. The fur is being modeled by our own Yancy Yarbrough, Miss Texas. Miss Texas 2000 will also enjoy living in her own luxury apartment, courtesy of Equity Residential Properties, represented by Lowell Prophet. And her apartment will be tastefully and elegantly furnished by Court Furniture Rentals, represented by Todd Shell. Let's show our appreciation for each of these firms' generosity in making our new Miss Texas year so beautiful and comfortable.
That's right. While every contestant in tonight's pageant receives an educational scholarship, we want to recognize the accomplishments of four non-finalist winners, three in talent and one in interview. In talent, the non-finalist winners are Miss Hunt County, Sarah Sheffield. Miss Rio Grande Valley, Jennifer Charlow. Miss Lone Star, Melissa Pritchett. And in interview, the non-finalist winner is Miss White Settlement, Adriana Elizondo.
And now we come to the second most important announcement of the evening. We wish each of you the very best.
This is a big one.
Oh boy. Our five finalists in random order are
Miss Gulf Coast Cindy Elizondo.
Miss Fort Worth Marshawn Evans.
Miss Harris County, Tori White.
Miss Hurst, Euless Bedford, Tara Watson.
And Miss Oak Cliff, Brooke Bowie.
Excited, lovely young women on our stage right now. Congratulations to each of them. To provide an opportunity to get to know the top five finalists, they will visit with Frank for the final on-stage interview competition. Frank, they're all yours.
Well, here we are. Just want to take a deep breath. I know, me too. This part's exciting. I have questions for each of you. This is a great chance to get to know our five finalists and find out a little bit more about you and about your platform. So let's start with a not-so-easy question, but we'll go from a kind of easy one to a much tougher one. All right, let's start with Miss Gulf Coast, Cindy Elizondo.
Hello.
Cindy, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Now, you're majoring in biomedical science.
Yes.
With a goal to attend medical school. Do you hope to enter private practice, or will you go into medical research?
Well, part of hematology, oncology, and pediatrics requires a part where I do have a year of research, so I do my own cancer research. So after taking national board exams, I will do some sort of research. I've already done some research in colon cancer, so I will continue probably in that, and then go on and be able to have a private practice, most definitely, and be able to work one-on-one with children, as well as do some counseling with them as well. I think that'd be an excellent opportunity.
All right. Miss Fort Worth. Hello, Marshawn. Congratulations. Now,
you
have been selected as a Truman Scholar. What's
yes.
a Truman Scholar, and how did you get selected?
Well, it was an amazing process. The Truman Scholarship is an award given on the behalf of Harry S. Truman, our former president, and it's a $30,000 scholarship for law school or graduate school for those who are pursuing a career in public service. And I do want to go on to participate or be involved in a career in the area of juvenile justice, and $30,000 will certainly come in handy to law school.
Yes, it would. Good answer. Ms. Harris County.
Hi, Frank.
I know where that is. Tori White. Now, you hope to practice international corporate law. Do you feel that we live in a litigation-happy society?
Absolutely, but it's one that where the system works. We have an opportunity in our society to defend justice for people who wouldn't get an opportunity otherwise. And so, though litigation is excessive, it is an opportunity for people to get justice.
All right. Ms. Hurst Euless Bedford, hello, Tara Watson.
Hello.
As a part-time dance teacher and choreographer, what lessons other than dance itself do you hope to impart to your students?
I think just to be able to set goals, that's been one of the neatest things I've been able to do, is to watch kids who have said, I want to be able to do a triple, and to start out at a single and go to a double, and just be able to reach that goal that they set. And you know, there are times that it's very difficult for them, but if we teach them that as long as they really have a drive to do it and they feel very confident in themselves, that they seem to reach that goal higher and faster than most kids who just say, oh, I can't do it, and they give up on it.
All right. Miss Oak Cliff, Brooke Bowie. Now, I understand that you recorded a gospel album.
Yes, I have.
That's pretty good. To what do you attribute the recent rise in popularity of contemporary Christian music?
Well, I think the sound has been mainstreamed. For a long time, contemporary Christian music sounded very different from the music that we listened to on the radio. And now when you turn on Christian radio, a lot of times you don't realize you're listening to Christian radio. So the sound is very much the same, and it's something that's pleasing to a lot of different ears.
Good answer. All right, now we get to your platforms. So we go back down here to Cindy. Cindy Elizondo, Miss Gulf Coast. In your platform, Pediatric Cancer Awareness, you mentioned the difficulty of motivating these young patients to fight the psychological as well as the physical battle. I'm sure that's very difficult.
Yes.
Now, what are ways that you help these children adjust just to being innocent victims of such a horrible disease?
Number one, doctors, physicians, nurses, counselors, we have to listen. We have to understand that just holding their hands alone makes them understand that there is a calmness. We have prevention, we have education, we have hope. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of a cure. So we have to understand that there are people there out there for them. The psychological impact is absolutely incredible. These are young children. We can motivate them. They are our leaders. There is breakthroughs in medical technology, and having tons of compassion helps them get through that psychological part.
Okay, thank you, Cindy.
Thank you.
Miss Fort Worth, Marshawn Evans. Regarding your work in juvenile crime prevention, you state that prevention is the only key to stopping violence that is destroying children and communities. What successes have you experienced with your United Against Crime program?
Well, it's been tremendously amazing over the past 5 years working in the area. But I think the most experience that stands out the most is when I decided to go and work in the juvenile detention center. And I worked with a young man who had been in countless experiences with the law and had gone from having intense behavioral problems. And we came to a point where we were talking about setting goals, and this was a huge step for him. And so I do realize that when we increase the protective factors by giving young people positive role models and things that they can strive for, giving them a vision that they can become resilient and they can stand up to the pressures that face them in spite of adversity.
Good answer. Thank you. Miss Harris County, Tori White. Your platform efforts stress empowering America's workforce with technology resources. Now, what do you find are the biggest challenges that employers face in restructuring their workforce to one that is not only comfortable with the digital world, but embraces all the technological advances that these innovations bring forth?
Well, I think there's two challenges. The first is locating in a place that is wired for talent. They need to approach cities that have resources in their people. Their human capital happens to be their most valuable resources, and so that's the first challenge for cities. The second one would be finding people who are capable of being flexible and changing. Change is imminent in our society today, and in order for companies to be proactive, they need to have people who are capable of being flexible.
All right. Ms. Hurstulis Bedford, Tara Watson. Tara, your platform concerns AIDS awareness and education. And in many demographic groups, AIDS numbers are actually declining, although the overall cases continue to rise at alarming rates. So what do we do to enlighten people of the fact that this is still a major health crisis worldwide?
I think the problem is that the statistics that we're hearing that the death rate is decreasing. No one is bothering to tell anyone that the newly infectious rate are increasing. It is stated that nearly 1,600 people a day are infected, and they have no clue that they've been infected. They're going out and infecting others because they're not being tested. We need to encourage testing. We need to let them know that they're not going to be discriminated against. I truly believe that we have decayed the AIDS issue, the AIDS virus, and I hope and pray that we do that. But we've got to get back and educate our youth. We've got to get into the high schools and the junior highs and get into those elementary schools at a young, young age and let them know the dangers of what it can do to your life.
All right, good answer. Miss Oak Cliff, Brooke Bowie. Now, you've been very involved in working with at-risk youth through the Jobs Corps program.
Do you feel that providing technical training and career guidance is enough to get these young people back on their feet? Or should more be done to channel these youth into being more productive members of society?
Well, actually, the two things that you mentioned are not the only two things that Job Corps does. They are, they do receive technical training, a vocation. They also are able to finish their basic education, but then they also receive personal counseling, very intense personal counseling. And this is what really causes the change. These students are missing some of the basic building blocks that a lot of us take for granted, things like shelter and feeling secure. And once you provide these things, as well as a vocation and the ability to finish their education, these young people are absolutely unstoppable.
Wow. Well, what can I say? The judges here, as usual, have a very tough go of it. If you would like to become a part of the Miss Texas Scholarship Program, here's how. Gloria?
I sure will, Frank. To be eligible to participate as a contestant must be between the ages of 17 and 24 and a high school graduate or equivalent. If you're interested in competing in a local pageant or would like information on organizing a local pageant, write to Miss Texas Organization, P.O. Box 100009, Fort Worth, Texas 76185. Or visit our website at www.misstexas.org. The big moment is about to arrive, so don't go away. We'll be right back after this message from Nice and Easy from Clairol. It's the true color of you.
People always ask me where I got my auburn hair. From my mother.
Our mother's hair is
Texas pageant. Good luck, ladies, and we'll see you all at Chili's.
Well, after taking my show people all over Europe, I figured it was time to see more of the world. After all, as the most famous and recognizable man in the world at the turn of the century, it only seemed right to take my crew of talented performers to another place we had never been, South America. What a delight that was. The bright costumes, the enticement of new instruments, and a Latin beat you just had to dance to.
And don't go away. We're about to meet our new Miss Texas after this word from Miss Baird's, a Texas tradition since 1908. Fresh from the oven, straight from the heart. Stay with us.
Know what I'm thinking about?
Nope.
About how my mom used to make me sandwiches with Mrs. Baird's bread when I was a kid.
Before we name our new Miss Texas, let's say a final farewell to Yancey Yarbrough and take a look at her past year of service as Miss Texas.
If someone had asked me this time last year about being Miss Texas, I would have told them that it would be a great job. As I reflect on my year, I now know that it is so much more. I have had the amazing responsibility of warning young people about the dangers of using drugs this year. In almost 200 school programs, I've spoken to thousands of students about making conscious decisions to make their lives better instead of making them worse. There are so many people to thank for allowing me to be in this position. The Hurstfields Bedford Pageant and Community, my friend Amy Bowman, without whom I wouldn't have made it, my traveling companions who have become friends and mentors, the Miss Texas CEO, Barry Hall, and President, Bob Moran, Executive Director and Mr. Texas himself, Gene and Beaton Magnus, my business manager, Nancy Marston, whose constant support and hard work have made my year unforgettable. You will be missed. And finally, to my family. Coming from a competitive rodeo family from Childress, I never quite made it as a cowgirl. I've always been more interested in singing, but because of their love and encouragement to follow God's plan for my life, I have stepped into this arena. And what a better way to be a true cowgirl than to represent the state of Texas. May God bless you, and God bless Texas.
Yancey Yarbrough. You know, Gloria, in addition to her scholarship awards tonight, our new Miss Texas will be getting a brand new Chevrolet Blazer as she begins her journey representing the great state of Texas. Here in our audience representing the Chevrolet Motor Division is Assistant Regional Divisional Marketing Manager Nate Love. Nate, please stand up and take a bow.
Thank you,
Thank you, Mr. Love. So much. And Chevrolet's incredible generosity and support of the Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant.
Well, folks, this is it. The most exciting announcement of the evening. Here is the decision of our panel of judges.
The fourth runner-up and winner of a $2,000 cash scholarship is Miss Gulf Coast Cindy Elizondo.
Third runner-up and winner of a $4,000 cash scholarship is Miss Fort Worth Marshawn Evans.
The second runner-up and winner of a $6,000 cash scholarship is Miss Harris County Tori White.
Here are two outstanding and very excited young women. One of them will receive an $8,000 scholarship as first runner-up, and the other will receive a $10,000 scholarship and the title of Miss Texas 2000. The first runner-up and winner of the $8,000 scholarship is Miss Oak Cliff Brooke. And our new Miss Texas is Miss Hurstfields Bedford, Tara. What an exciting evening! On behalf of the Miss Texas organization, thank you for joining us tonight. Don't forget to watch on October 14th when our new Miss Texas competes in the Miss America Pageant in Atlantic City. Good night, everyone.
Good night, Gloria. Bye. Good night, everybody.
Scholarship package has been brought to you by Chevrolet. Chevy will be there. Nice and easy from Clairol. It's the true color of you. Lotto Texas, Scratch Games, the Miss Texas Scholarship Package. What do they all have in common? They can make people winners. And they're all brought to you courtesy of the Texas Lottery. Good luck, everybody. Chili's Grill and Bar, proud sponsor of the 2000 Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant, and proud to have been serving Texas for more than 25 years. We'll see you all at Chili's. This has been a special presentation of Lombardo and Associates.